Greetings, students and parents. This is Mary Ray, District Instructional Technology Specialist for East Central ISD. In Episode 2 of the Google Classroom Students Series, we're going to look at the process for turning in your work to Google Classroom. First, we'll look at the process when using a computer or laptop, and then we will walk through the steps for using a personal device, such as a tablet or a phone. I'll first show you the process for using a computer or laptop. Once you've opened up Google Classroom, you'll see the classes page with all of the cards for your different classrooms. To open your classroom, you're going to click on the title of the class, and then it will open up in Google Classroom. You'll first be seeing the stream page, so you'll want to click the Classwork tab to open up the page where you'll see all of the assignments, questions, and resources that your teacher has shared with the student. We're going to begin by opening a question. And there are two types of questions, a multiple choice or a short answer. This particular question, "What do you miss most about being at school?" is a short answer question, and you'll type your answer over here. What do you miss most about being at school? Chicken nuggets on Tuesday. You're also going to notice that you can post comments. The first type of comment is a class comment. These comments can be seen by all students in the class. The second type of comment is a private comment. These comments go directly to the teacher and cannot be seen by any other student. Finally, you're ready to turn in your work by clicking the Turn In button and clicking Turn In on the pop-up window. When you're ready to go back to your classroom, you're going to look up in the left-hand corner and click on the title of your classroom. This will take you back to the stream page, and you'll simply click on the Classwork tab, where you'll notice that your question now has been marked as turned in. We can collapse this question and go on to question number 2. This particular question is a multiple choice question, so you can answer it directly on the classwork screen. How are you accessing Google Classroom? Well, I'm currently accessing it on a laptop, so I will select the top choice. I've answered the question, so now I can simply click the Turn In button and click Turn In on the pop-up window. So those are the two types of questions. Now we're going to move on to assignments. And there are two ways to submit evidence of your work. We're going to look at the first option by clicking on the Week 1 assignment. In this assignment, the teacher is asking the students to attach evidence to the assignment by adding pictures, videos, files from Google Drive, by attaching images, videos, PDFs, etc. from their computer or their tablet or phone, or even by creating a new document in Google Drive. Please notice that it is important that you don't click the Turn In button until after you have submitted all of the work for Week 1. So, for example, if you have assignments that you've completed on Monday, you can attach those to the assignment, but do not click the Turn In button. Then you can come back and you can attach more work on Tuesday, more work on Wednesday, and you'll wait until the end of Week 1 after you have uploaded all of your work, and then you will click the Turn In button. To upload our work, we must first click the View Assignment to open the assignment details. I'm going to click out of this pop-up window, and here in the assignment window, you can see an Add or Create button. This is where you will attach the work that you want to submit. There are several ways to do that. First is by uploading from Google Drive. You can also attach a link if you've been completing work on an online site. Or you can upload a file that you have saved on your computer, laptop, or tablet. There is also an option where you can actually create new documents. You can create a new Google Doc, a slide presentation, a Sheets spreadsheet, or even a Google Drawing. Let's walk through the process of attaching a file from your device. Click the File button, and then you're going to search your computer for the file you want to upload, select the file, and then click the Open button. The file will be added in the top of the window, and then you can choose to add more files at this time, or you can simply click the Upload button, and your file will be automatically attached to the assignment. Remember, you do not want to mark the assignment as done or turn the assignment in until after you have attached all of the work for this particular assignment. I'm going to X out of this particular window, and I will go back to the Add or Create button so that I can attach another file. In this particular case, I'm going to create a new Google document by clicking on the Docs button. As you can see, Google Classroom begins the process of automatically creating a Google Doc document for me and then opening the doc in a new tab. A Google Docs document is very similar to a Microsoft Office Word document. The student will simply type their work into the document, and it is automatically saved in Drive for them. When finished, the student simply exits out of the tab, and they will see that the document is automatically attached to their Week 1 assignment. Remember, you do not want to click the Turn In button until you have finished attaching all evidence for your Week 1 assignment. To return to the classroom, we'll click the title and then click the Classwork tab. And now we're going to look at the Week 2 assignment. In this particular example, the teacher has actually created a document and already attached it to the assignment for the student to work in. So in this instance, the student will simply click on the document to open the document, and the document will automatically open in Google Drive, and it will be available for the student to edit. When finished, simply close the tab, and you are back in the assignment. It's important to remember not to turn in your work until you are finished, especially with a Google document. Once a Google document has been turned in as part of an assignment, the document is locked and the student will no longer be able to edit it. So be sure that you do not click the Turn In button until you have finished adding all of the necessary information to your Google document. To return to the classroom, simply click on the title and then click on the Classwork tab. Now let's look at the process on a tablet. I've already opened the Google Classroom app, so I'm simply going to click on the title of the classroom that I want to open. When the classroom opens, you'll remember that on a tablet, the pages are listed down at the bottom. So to navigate to the Classwork tab, I'm going to click the Classwork link at the bottom. This will open the Classwork page where all of the assignments, the questions, the resources, etc. that the teacher has posted will be listed. We're going to walk through the process of answering the questions first. So let's click on the first question, and it opens in a new window. You can see that there is an area where you type in your answer. This is a short answer question. So the question, "What do you miss most about school?" I miss my friends. Once I've finished typing, I click the Turn In button, and then I click Submit, and my answer is recorded. Once again, I have the ability to post comments. I can add a class comment that is visible by all students in the class, or I can add a private comment that is only visible to the teacher. None of the students in my class will be able to see a private comment. You'll use the back arrow in the upper left-hand corner to navigate back to the classwork page. And now we're going to look at the second question type. This is a multiple choice question. How are you accessing Google Classroom? Well, I'm currently using a tablet. Then I click Turn In and I click the Submit button. Once I've submitted my response, a class summary appears on the page if the teacher has turned this particular feature on. I can see a summary of the responses submitted by all of the students in the classroom, but I cannot see which student supplied which answer. It's anonymous. And this is only if the teacher has turned this particular feature on. Once again, I have the ability to add a class comment or a private comment. Use the back button to go back to the classroom. And now let's look at our first assignment. In this week one assignment, again, the teacher is asking students to upload or attach their evidence in the form of Google Drive files or images or videos, etc. They can also create a new Google document. So to attach files, I'm going to click on the little arrow down in the bottom area where it says Your Work, and this will expand that window. To upload a file, click Add Attachment, and then select an option. The first option is Google Drive. This will open my Google Drive account, and I can select a file to attach to my assignment. You can see the file has already attached to this particular assignment. Other options for adding attachments are adding links, uploading files, or picking photos. If you're taking pictures of your child's work or video recording their work as evidence, you can upload those pictures and images from your device's camera roll. Simply select the photo from your camera roll, and it will automatically upload into Google Classroom and attach to the assignment. To create a new document, click Add Attachment, and then select New Docs at the bottom of the screen. A new Google document will be opened in the Google Docs app. So it's important that you have also installed the Google Docs app on your device if you want your student to create new documents. The new document will open. It will be ready for editing. Simply click the pencil in the bottom right corner to enable editing of the document. Click the classroom link in the upper left-hand corner to return to Google Classroom. You will now see that the new document is attached in Google Classroom. Remember, you do not want to turn in your work until you have completed uploading all attachments that you want to submit for this particular assignment. It is also important to remember that a Google Doc can no longer be edited once it has been turned in with an assignment. Students can also comment privately on their assignment, and this message will be sent directly to the teacher. No other students in the classroom will be able to see the comment. To exit the assignment, you first need to click the arrow at the top of the screen to collapse the Your Work area. Then you will use the back arrow in the upper left-hand corner to return to the classwork screen. Now we'll open Week 2 assignment. In the Week 2 assignment, once again, you'll notice the directions state that the teacher has created a document for the student. You will expand the Your Work area by clicking on the arrow, and here you will see that the teacher has already created a document for the student. Click on the document to open it, and in this instance, you'll see that the shared document has actually opened up within Google Classroom. The pencil icon in the upper right-hand corner allows the student to annotate on the document, but they cannot edit it. To edit the document, The student will need to click on the expand icon in the upper right-hand corner. This will then open the document within the Google Docs app, and the student will now be able to click on the pencil icon in the lower right-hand corner and actually edit the document. Use the classroom link in the upper left-hand corner to return to Google Classroom, then click the X to close the document, and it will take you back to the assignment. Once again, remember, do not click the Turn In button until you are finished editing the document. Once the document has been turned in as part of an assignment, the student will no longer be able to edit the document until the teacher returns it. Click the upper arrow to close the Your Work section, and then use the back arrow to take you back to the Google Classroom page. This concludes the second episode of the Google Classroom Student Series. Remember, if you have any questions or encounter any problems, please do not hesitate to contact your classroom teacher.